interesting, this old technology, the miles on this car cluster dash, the way this worked with physical digits. So you had a small motor here, was plugged into the dash with the information from the wheels. I have these gears here, and you can actually spin the gears. Obviously would have been spun by the electric motor, and just pile up this one being kilometers, but the miles would be the same. And can also have this counter here that would spin at the same time. There's like a small road in between the two. And I was trying to see if I can roll back. So this is the normal rotation of the motor. Now, if you try to go the other way so as to roll back the odometer, it stops, it rolls a little bit, and then it's like it's blocked, it cannot go more. I don't know why, perhaps it has an anti-roll mechanism. Obviously, the smart guy did figure out how to roll back these things, because it was very much done back in the days. And usually when you roll it back, you kind of force it and the digits get misaligned at some place. This one, there's the 7, it's a little bit misaligned. You can just look at the edge. This one, but generally speaking, these digits, the 6 digits, are pretty much correctly aligned. But if you would try to roll this thing back, you'll perhaps force on it. See, now it's stuck. You will perhaps force on the digit and they will jump and start being misaligned. And that's how you'd see back then if a car had a rolled back a trafficked odometer. It was very, very common, and it's still common with the digital ones also. It feels actually, it seems it's easier to roll back a digital odometer than it was to roll back this mechanical old one. So the only way to know if a car it has a trafficked odometer is just to see into the history of maintenance of the car, Carfax, and just check the numbers, check the mileage readings throughout the years of the car ownership. All right, thanks for watching.